Hi friends, Chad from Figma here with a little tip for using library analytics to understand where and how your design system library assets are being used with Figma. We can see the analytics for any library in our organization that we have at least view access to. And there's a couple of ways to open the analytics window. So let's take a look. In the file browser, we can navigate to a library file, and then right-click on the cover to open library analytics. Or we can open a library file either via the browser or, if we're an admin, from the resources section in admin settings, and then use the drop-down right next to the file name and open analytics from there. Now first, we'll see an overview of the contents of the library. Let's switch over to the Analytics tab to learn a little bit more about our Earthling SDS library here. Here we can see an overview of the top teams using the components from this library, along with info about each component and how often it's been used. Something else that we can see in Analytics is how and where our styles and variables are being used by changing the type dropdown at the top of the window. So, how can this info help us? Well, if we are library maintainers, it can give us insight into what pieces of our library are being used the most often, or what's not. Here we can sort by how many instances have been used, those that were inserted recently, or even those that have been detached. Let's say that we're going to revamp our color palettes and update some colors or maybe even remove some levels of hierarchy. Before we just go changing or removing things, we should probably take a look at what styles, components, or other variables would be impacted by these changes. So I'm going to sort our variables here by inserts over the last 30 days. And let's take a look at our tertiary brand text color and where it's being used since we're going to update it. By selecting the variable, here we can see the files that are using it across all open teams in the organization or those that we're a part of. And if we want or need to really dive in and see exactly where this color is being applied in a given file, clicking on the file name will open it, and here we can take a peek around in the file to see where it's being used. Now, when it comes to locating colors within a file, one thing that I like to do is select all and then use the selection colors to narrow down what I'm looking for. So on a Mac, press Command A to select all, or Control plus A on a PC, and then go to our selection colors section in the design panel and click on Show Selection Colors. We can expand that out and find our tertiary brand text, and on hover, we can click on the target icon to select everywhere this variable is being used across this page. Now, this text is intended to be used on darker background colors, and it looks like it is in this case. So if we use analytics to take a look at where and how assets are being used, we can be more informed about what impact changes will have and if we're going ahead with a smooth minor update or if it looks like it's going to be something larger that could require additional communication or even introduce breaking changes. Speaking of breaking changes, another way that library analytics can help us as maintainers is showing what variants for a component may not be used that often and could be a candidate for deprecation. Like in this title chip here, we can see our brand variant isn't used at all. It could also tell us about components that have been detached and give us insight. You know, maybe we need to see, are they designed too complex? Do they need to support more use cases? Or maybe our team need to provide a bit more education and support around usage. Are you using library analytics today? What insights have been the most useful? Let us know in the comments. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.